All right, so we just came to Dixie four-wheel drive, and I get asked often what's all done with our Jeep, and the answer is I have no idea. So we decided to come over here and make these guys explain a few things. Very candid, put them on the spot a little bit, see if they'll remember everything.
Jeep Gladiator.
I'm gonna put you on the spot. Right, I didn't give Bryce any forewarning about this.
All right, let's go for it. I'm good with
it. All right, so everybody asked me what I did to this, and the answer is I have no idea.
It's easy.
Okay.
On a JT, what's cool, if you buy a Rubicon versus a non-Rubicon, you get what's called a highline fender. So this fender comes up a little bit higher. What you notice is we trimmed it away. We still put a light to retain your blinker and an inner fender so that we could fit a really large tire. What's cool is you can actually turn. These are called Zeus fasteners, and you can actually turn them and pop it out. They call it quick release fenders. So these are made by American Adventure Lab, but it's meant to be a nice inner fender well, but giving you clearance to run less of a lift with a larger tire. This is a 39 inch tall tire.
I put 40s?
You could put a 40 on it. We went 39 because you were driving it on the highway, gonna be dragging behind an RV. Like there was a few things within that. 17 inch wheel. We had to do a little bit deeper offset to help clear the steering, but it's a 3.5 inch Terraflex long arm in the front, which is with Fox 3.0 shocks. These are the Fox 3.0 shocks with the really big reservoir. You get the dual speed adjuster, so you're able to adjust low speed and high speed of the shock, not vehicle speed, but shock speed. We also upgrade you with big, beefy 2.5 ton steering, which is solid aluminum by RPM steering, so with the apex ends on it. And then it's still the factory Rubicon axles, but we did gear them so that it was really close to the equivalent of a stock. That way, you know, you probably have good drivability for the size of the tire that's there. We got the Fox 2.0 bump stops. So the last 2 inches of the travel, you're hitting this bump to actually cushion it for those hard hits. That way you're not relying on just the shock. The other thing that's set up to do is stop this tire from hitting the fender or anything like that.
So that still moves right there.
You can see actually the last little bit, you haven't been hitting all of it. You got half of it, but you haven't bottomed it out all the way yet.
Every time I hit, I wonder.
You wonder. Well, that's a good way to know it. We went with an aluminum Genrite stubby bumper. These things are big, so the lighter we can keep it, the better off we are. This has the front camera option, so it gives you good visibility right out the front, like you probably see when you click on your front camera. We did all rigid lighting to give us, you know, A, the round look that you wanted, but B, the brightness without being really big, noisy light bar or something like that up top. This is, come around the side of it, you can see Rock Slide Engineering. They're a Utah company up in Logan.
Open that door, right? Yeah.
What's cool is they drop down 12 inches, making it, you know, when you get into a really big Jeep, it makes it really easy, especially when you go to get in the back seat. The back seat's the hardest, you know. You got the smaller door opening, and the step is crucial when you go to get in that lifted. You'll end up taking yourself out on this door latch right here if you try to jump out without the steps. What's cool is they run a magnet off the door to trigger the actual step to come up, and then you'll see it there. Because we knew you were going to go rock crawl, we added the extra, what they call skid plate, but it's an extra protection around
on the outside.
The whole step to give it a little extra.
I love that thing, circling around rocks.
To help pivot yourself.
Everybody always worries.
So when we said long arm up front, this is a short arm. Short arm means it goes to factory coil, you know, your control arms go to the factory frame mounts. The front's a long arm, which you can tell they're a lot longer on the front if you compare the length of these control arms. The longer the control arm, in this regards to the lift kit, it helps recorrect the geometry. So if you think of this being your control arm, your Jeep had no lift, it went up, it went down. Now we lifted it, right, and you got that steeper angle. Refixing that helps keep the axle in a better geometry line for vertical, but also how it handles, how you feel potholes in the bumps. I'm sure, like, you know, it rides good.
Sure.
Again, with the 39s, you can see in the high line in the fender, we actually did the AL inner fenders. And then you also have what's called the anti-rock rear sway bar. The reason we went to an anti-rock rear sway bar is your front Rubicon and four low, you're able to disconnect it. If you were to have no sway bars, the vehicle would have a lot of roll to it. When you disconnect just the front, I'm sure you noticed that. this helps compensate. We add a little stiffer to the rear and it helps work with it in four low when it's not, but then on the highway it drives extra tight when you're actually going high speeds, dirt roading, freeway driving,
yeah,
to the gorge, you know what I mean.
Any cool.
All Rubicon models came with a steel rear bumper. This on the Gladiator is the most important part. This gets drug all the time probably, and then as well as your receiver hitch, like you can see you've already bent it up.
Yeah.
So
that's your fault.
And then you got a tonneau cover here to kind of lock all the goodies in, you know, when you're daily driving, in this case grocery shopping
after you go to Costco.
Costco run. But that's,
so tell me about the
Apex valve stems?
Yeah.
So these are pretty trick. What's your tire pressure at right now?
Like 12.
Okay, I won't go much. What's really cool about this Apex valve stem, traditionally you would get like a, what they call a monster valve. Watch how this thing's open. When I open this up, there's going to be five little...
You kind of can't even see it because it's... You got really large holes on there. So is this what's in your factory valve stem hole with any aftermarket wheel? They make a... XL or a smaller one, that's just really the depth of it. What's neat is it airs up quicker than a traditional valve stem. Not only does it air down, it'll take, I don't know on this tire, but I know it can take our 43 1550 20 inch wheel, so that's a huge tire on our Gladiator. It can take it from like 25 to 8 in literally like 6 seconds, 7
wow.
seconds. It's unbelievable how fast it just,
so it just allows
it just dumps out so much pressure. More so when you go to air up, air down, this is a brand new product. Like, this is not even a year old product. So it's a very new, but it's on my personal vehicle, it's on yours. We've sold already, we've easily sold 100 of those things. No, well, way more than 100. We've done way more than 100 if you count 4 or 5 per wheel of every vehicle.
Yeah.
But so definitely a neat thing.
What about my compressor?
We got two cool things that we haven't touched into. One is Red Dot Engineering makes this super slick compressor mount. What it does, it actually mounts a dual ARB right underneath your seat, and yours is probably tied into your auxiliary switch.
Yeah,
so you just hit the factory auxiliary switch, which key would have to be on, that would kick it right here. But what's cool is it's a standard fitting, so you can air out the Jeep, spray it out, you can air up an air mattress if you're camping, or just air up a tire. So pretty cool little feature. One other feature that's kind of out of sight, out of mind, it's really hard to see, but if you peek your head in here, there's a cooler in there.
Mm-hmm.
What's more neat than that, and we'll come around to this side. This Jeep has, can't even see it because it's so tucked in behind here, an electric power steering pump that sits right behind this inner fender. So your steering is actually electric, right? We put a gauge on it and we turned up the factory pump. We were able to push it to like, I want to say close to 2,500 pounds. So we're with the factory electric. So it helps steer, you know, when you turn on the front locker or you get just a more offset wheel like this. It helps the steering, you know, to keep that electric power steering, but pump it up just a little bit more. But that's about the extent of the build. That kind of covers almost everything on it, right? Short
Love
of the
it.
Winch, and that's it, right?
That's all.
So it's a diesel. What kind of mileage are you pulling on this
thing? I love this thing. It's only got stuck once.
Stuck once, but where? In Alaska, in mud.
Winch. It's broke. Jeep
stuck.
What a day.
And the tire, I mean, you were pushing both, you know.
The axles were completely buried. It was not good.
And I got the phone call still in the middle of the night.
What do I do? So, I'll just say I'm grateful for Dixie 4x4. They have been incredible. To work with. When I bought this, I did a bunch of research who to use, and these guys came up first, and so I called Bryce. They went and picked it up at the dealership, and
we did a lot of it over the phone. It was back and forth education between text messages, phone calls.
I didn't even see it for like 2 months after you did it. So anyway, we're
so
grateful.
So it was a fun project.
So thank you.
Tell me what you want.
and a bit of a pickle